also in the deal was Jae Crowder, which it feels kind of weird now because Jae Crowder has been around Boston longer than Isaiah Thomas, and he's no slouch. He was just starting forward on this team. Do you think he's got kind of getting overlooked in this trade and what the Celtics are losing?
100%. Yeah, I think Crowder, a lot of people kind of, I don't know, bashed Crowder's defense last season. You know, he did take a small step back, especially in terms of on-ball defense. But the truth of the matter is that he was long, strong, just a really smart defender, just really cerebral. He knew where to be. He bought into the Celtics schemes, and he just really became a key part of the team's defense. The Celtics are going to struggle next year, you know, on defense, unless Jaylen Brown takes like a huge step forward or Jason Tatum is ready to contribute right out of the gate. It's going to be really tough for them. They built an entire team defensively around defending around Isaiah Thomas. You know, he was a big minus defensively, and they still managed to be a passable defensive team because they were able to be very versatile. And Crowder was a huge part of that. He could defend 2 through 4. He could, you know, really make up for Thomas's deficiencies. And that would have been big to keep him around, especially with Irving coming in, who was also a defensive minus, you know. So he's a big loss. He really took a lot of steps forward offensively as well. And, you know, he's been with the team since that Rondo trade where everybody kind of thought the Celtics got fleeced a little bit. And then as it turned out, Crowder was the reason why the Mavericks got fleeced. So he's a huge loss, big locker room presence, just an ultimate professional. I personally just really enjoyed covering him. I really enjoyed getting to interview him a few times. He was always very candid, always very polite, just a really nice guy in that way. And Celtics are really going to miss him, you know, on the court as well.